6 years? Ever since the scandal that ruined her career.
Are you kidding? That's the perfect marriage.
Well, I'm sorry to burst your bubble of finely aged cynicism, but the Yeases are genuinely crazy about each other.
Mr. Yates, it's Aaron, sir, from the firm. I came as quickly as I could. Yes, sir, I have the file. Sorry it took so long, but I had to hand it out. I'm sure the print will be saying.
Bienvenidos a tu viñeda, Yates. May I see your invitation, please? Gracias, señor. Enjoy the party.
Don't stare. He's
busted heads for less. The man's a beast.
Corvo, got a message from the boss. Duty calls.
Let me guess, the Burnwood woman.
That's right. Yates has arranged for the chief winemaker to take Burnwood and Tamara Vidal on a grand tour of the estate. Wants you to tag along.
Not for my sparkling personality. This Burnwood woman sure has his panties in a twist. Wonder what the deal is.
Yates' business is his business. Just get yourself ready and sign into the visitor center. Have a drink on my behalf.
Don't drink.
A private tour of the estate. Diana, Vidal, and this fixer, Corvo Black. Black is a threat, but also an opportunity. Yates' own machinations are inconsequential. Joining the tour will give access to Vidal, away from the crowd.
It's me sentimental.
Rare for privilege. You and Lord Yates must be very close. Yes. 400.
Mr. Yates. Yeah, I got your message. You aren't telling me what I'm...
...party like your guests inexplicably have been dead.
Who were they again?
Yeah.
A couple of old lunch Dion.
In fact, a couple of spots come to mind. On the tour or after.
I bet
you know. Stand by. So you're not sure yet? Does that mean there's a plan A? One where I don't stand a 50-50 chance of getting caught? I mean, you do realise the risk here, boss. Broad daylight, workers around. But when an ass is pissing on your parade.
You're resting, you say? He's not even been appointed.
Yeah, all right. But if I'm going to be one of these heralds of yours, you need to start letting me in on a few things.
The wine list?
Okay.
I'm more of a beer man myself, but if Yates wants to bring the heralds closer together and play the modern boss, I don't actually mind. Edwards always was a bit aloof.
I just never framed an urban legend before. Very post-truth.
He is Edwards' closest legal advisor. Not even Thomas Cross or Eugene Cobb had a direct line of contact. I'd say Yates is at the top of a very short list.
So, how do you feel about Burnwood?
How do you think? She and her friends killed Yamazaki.
Oh,
and welcome to the Yates Wine.
Corval Black. I'm on the tour.
Right. Mr. Black. Welcome. Miss Burnwood and Miss Vidal will meet you down by the wine fields. I trust you know the way.
I can find my way around.
Enjoy the tour.
Over here.
You two must be Burnwood and Vidal.
And you must be Yates's garbage man. Sorry, but I didn't catch your name.
This is Corvo Black, Tamara. He's a ICA regular.
I only work with the best.
Well, we're all here, it seems. Except for our guide, the chief winemaker. Looks like we're stuck here until someone fetches him. Mr. Black, I'm looking in your direction.
Hold on. I'll track him down.
Attaboy. Do try and bring him back in one piece. Counterintuitive as that may be.
That was a bit rude.
Yeah.
Johannes.
Yes, it was.
Our goal here is to be able to win. For 4 decades, I served the law. Now, I serve the law.
Señor Vargas.
What? What is he now? What?
You have some guests waiting. Senor Yates wanted you to give them grand tour, remember?
If I don't have more important things to babysit Yates' socialite friends, it's only harvest season.
Better do what he says, Patron. Big shot New York lawyer like that. Don't want to get on his bad side.
Well, I'm not going anywhere until I have decided to take off his wife for picking. Bring me the 3 Malbec grapes, Yates, Ramon. Yates doesn't like how I prioritize. He can weigh me down with concrete and toss me off a bridge. How's that?
3 grapes, was it? I'll get my picking knife.
Then I'm not gonna go. Uy, pero me gustaría.
What happened?
Let it go. I think he was just using me as a way to get out of this time.
Mr. Vargas, I have the three grapes you requested.
Yes, good. Bring him here. Now, let's see.
¿Cómo estás, chico?
¿Qué? ¿Quieres un beso?
Now, let's see. A lovely inky black color. Good size. Large and firm. Seeds brown. Excellent. Finally, taste. Mm. Sweet, flavorful, robust tannins. Some floral notes. Marvelous.
Why, I say these grapes are ripe for harvest. Inform the workers, will you, Ramon?
I have a third to contact.
Will do.
Decades I served the law. Now, I serve something far grander. I serve the land. In the land of many days and long to make it.
I grew up
the power
of
the bound together by the complicated of weird. Enter the Destiny Group, a fully legal.
Ah, yo, man. My fellow wine lover. Hello. Welcome to Viñeda Yates. I do apologize for the delay, but the Malbec grape. He's a demanding mistress. So, I am Gabriel Vargas, chief winemaker, and I will be your tour guide. Any questions before we start?
Yes, but you're not going to like them.
We're good. Lead the way, Senor Vargas.
Wonderful. Follow me. These are busy times. In fact, we're just about to harvest this year's crop. Great expectations. So, how do you like Argentina?
Like everywhere else, full of Americans.
First stop on the tour is the production floor, where our prize-winning Malbec grapes are processed. We insist on steaming every grape by hand, which means that during harvest season, the grapes do tend to pile up. Luckily, we have plenty of storage space. Our equipment is state-of-the-art, including an industrial-sized freezer unit, and last but not least, our trusty grape crusher.
Interesting. Wouldn't you say, Mr. Black?
Yes. Follow me, please.
Are you a wine man, Black? Somehow you don't seem the type.
Oh, I believe Mr. Black here is something of a jack of all trades. Isn't that so?
I dabble.
I see. I just thought Yates might be sending a message. My mistake.
So, have any of you been to our vineyard before?
Only on business.
Next on our tour is the fermentation atrium, where the wine goes to its primary stage of fermentation. In these big open tanks, yeast converts the sugars in the wine to alcohol in a process that lasts between 5 and 15 days. This is also where we squeeze the mass into a fine juice using our grape presser before the longer, secondary stage of fermentation.
Fascinating.
Now, before we move on, do any of you have questions?
How about you, Mr. Black? You look like you have something on your mind.
I have a question. Perhaps we can take a closer look.
Certainly. Lead the way.
What can you tell me about this device? Grape presser, was it?
That is correct, senor. After primary fermentation, the mass is pressed through a fine filter, leaving only the flesh and skins behind. I should add that Grape stomping, the iconic practice of crushing grapes with your bare feet, is historically rare and mostly a tourist gimmick. But you are most welcome to try. Imagine you're a grape.
Thanks. I'll pass.
Oh, go on. I'll take a picture of the three of you.
Oh, come on, Tamara. When in Rome?
Fine.
Say queso.
May I see that, Mr. Vargas? I believe I blinked.
So, this is what the little guy feels like.
Nope, all good. Looks like one for the mantle.
Now, are there any more questions? Don't be shy.
I got all I need.
Are you enjoying yourself, Mr. Black?
Oh, it's all very inspiring.
Winemaking is a grumps. Sure, sure. Everyone talks about craft beer these days. You can make a decent IPA in your pantry. It is the best thing. No, this is my friends. This is true grandeur. Excelente. Let's continue to the barrel room. Follow me. So we arrive to our final stop, the barrel room. This is where we store the wine during the secondary stage of fermentation. The area behind the glass is where we keep our most precious bottles, including a 1945 Grand Paladin, the most expensive wine in existence. The access doors, which are made from ballistic glass, can only be unlocked from the security room high above our heads.
Remarkable.
Ah, here comes Senor Yates now. I shall leave you in his capable hands.
How reassuring.
Ah, Miss Burnwood, is it not? Don Yates, pleased to meet you. You come very highly recommended. As Chief of the Heralds, let me be the first to say welcome aboard.
Why, thank you, Mr. Yates. Rest assured that I will be following your every lead. Very closely.
Say, that reminds me. We're about to have a little Herald get-together up at the house. Just a modest toast to celebrate my forthcoming inauguration as Constant. You are, of course, most welcome to join us. I believe you shall make a fine Herald once the training wheels are off.
I wouldn't miss it for the world.
Capital, right this way, into the lion's den. Why don't you take a break, Corvo? We're done here for now, I think. Oh, but don't go too far. I may still need your services later.
I'll be closer than you think.
Station atrium, where the wine goes to its primary stage of fermentation. In these big open tanks, yeast converts the sugars in the wine to alcohol in a process that lasts between 5 and 15 days. This is also where we squeeze the mass into a fine juice using our grape presser for the longer, secondary stage of fermentation.
Fascinating.
Now, before we move on, do any of you have questions?
How about you, Mr. Black? You look like you have something on your mind.
I have a question. Perhaps we can take a closer look.
Certainly.
What
lead
can you
way.
Tell me about this device? Grape presser, was it?
That is correct, Senor. After primary fermentation, the mass is pressed through a fine filter, leaving only the flesh and skins behind. I should add that grape stomping, the iconic practice of crushing grapes with your bare feet, is historically rare and mostly a tourist gimmick. But you are most welcome to try. Imagine you're a grape.
Thanks. I'll pass.
Oh, go on. I'll take a picture of the three of you.
Oh, come on, Tamara. When in Rome?
Fine.
eso.
May I see that, Mr. Vargas? I believe I blinked.
So, this is what the little guy feels like.
No, all good. Looks like one for the man.
Any further questions? Get away. What happened to your colleague?
I don't think she'll be coming back.
Oh, well. I'm sure she can find her way out. Let's proceed. Next on our tour is the fermentation atrium, where the wine goes through its primary stage of fermentation. In these big open tanks, yeast converts the sugars in the wine to alcohol in a process that lasts between 5-15 days. This is also where we squeeze the mass into a fine juice using our grape presser before the longer secondary stage of fermentation.
Fascinating.
Now, before we move on, do any of you have questions?
How about you?
I have a question. It's... perhaps we can take a closer look.
Certainly. Lead the way.
What can you tell me about this grape crusher?
Well, as the name implies, it crushes the distilled grapes into a thick pulp or must, a powerful rotating cylinder. She is one of the most important appliances in our production pipeline.
Have you had any workplace accidents?
What? Fall into the vat and get crushed to a pulp? You'd have to be a bona fide idiot. Waste of space, if you ask me.
Yes, well, fortunately, we have had none of that. So, if there's no further questions? Yes. I just love to clean up the yes. And off! What happened to your colleague?
Urgent call. Something about work. I don't think she'll be coming back.
Oh, well.
I have no
idea
what that could have been.
Let's proceed. Excelente. Yeah, let's continue to the barrel room. If you'll follow me. Next on our tour is the fermentation atrium, where the wine goes through its primary stage of fermentation. These big open tanks, yeast converts the sugars in the wine to alcohol in a process that lasts between 5-15 days. This is also where we squeeze the mass into a fine juice using our grape presser for the longer secondary stage of fermentation.
Fascinating.
Now, before we move on, do any of
I have a question. It's... perhaps we can take a closer look.
Certainly. Lead the way.
What can you tell me about this freezer?
This is an industrial cold storage unit where we keep our excess grape stock to prevent decay. It easily reaches temperatures of minus 10 degrees Celsius. Trust me, you don't want to stay in here for long.
No kidding. Hey, there's no doorknob on the inside.
Okay. This is an industrial cold storage unit where we keep our... Now, there any more questions? Be shy.
I got all I need.
Excelente. So let's continue to the barrel room. Follow me.
I'm interested in these containers.
Ah, yes. Our large fermentation tanks are constructed from solid French oak and each container 500 gallons of gray must.
Interesting. Are those cooling sockets?
They are indeed, Senora. The cooling system allows us to fine-tune the entire process. Temperature, humidity levels, etc. Our goal here at Piñera Yates is quite simple. From the state-of-the-art winemaking facility to our carefully nurtured grape stock, hand-picked with loving care by local experts, we have only one purpose: to make the best vinos in Argentina and beyond.
Well, looks like an accident waiting to happen.
Occupational hazard. Eh, Burwood?
Paladin, the most expensive wine in existence. The access doors, which are made from ballistic glass, can only be unlocked from the security room high above our heads.
Remarkable.
Ah, here comes Senor Yates now. Good on you.
What?
And from what I got, it seems to be an accident. Yeah, pretty sure. Huh? All right, out.
No. Screw this.
Okay, I'm up. Give me a break, please.
What?
All is cool, all is cool.